In this video, we will explain how to add a DKIM record to your 20i registered domain name and explain all the different ways a DKIM record can be customized. To get started, the first thing that you'll need to do is ensure that you're signed into your My20i account. Head to the Manage Hosting section of your control panel. Click Options and then manage the package you are adding a DKIM record to. Once you're within the package section, locate the domain keys icon, then click to go into this. On this page, the first thing to do is to ensure you've selected the domain you are adding the DKIM record to. Now add a selector. This can be any value or name you like, as it's simply a field to identify the DKIM record. Then select Add Signature. The DKIM record has now been configured. If your name servers are with 20i, we'll automatically add the correct TXT record for you. If your name servers are elsewhere, you will need to add the DNS record for the DKIM to your DNS sub. The signature will be added immediately to emails sent from the mailboxes under the domain selected. The previous steps are all you need to configure a simple DKIM record. However, there are also advanced options you can use if you are familiar with customizing DKIM signatures. Some of the advanced options are as follows. The selector, this is a unique identifier for the DKIM record and can be set to any value you like. For example, you could set it to indicate the name of an office location. Service type. Currently, DKIM only supports signatures added to messages sent via email. However, in the future the DKIM standard may add more service types such as IM or VoIP, which will then be able to support. This field can be left to either asterisk or email, changing this won't influence behavior at present. Canonicalization. Some mail servers and relay systems may modify an email in transit, potentially invalidating a DKIM signature. There are two options you can set, simple and relaxed. If you expect your email to be modified in any way, you should select relaxed, which is more forgiving to changes made the header and body of the email. Expiry time. This is the time which, when elapsed, the DKIM signature will be invalidated in the mail header. By default, it's set to 86,400 seconds, one day. You may wish to extend this if you believe deliverability of the email will take longer than one day. Flags. There are two flags available, production and testing. If you select testing, you'll still receive a response to the email and the DKIM signature from the remote mail server, but the email won't be treated with different behavior. Verifier systems may wish to track testing mode results to assist the signer. You'll mostly want to use production. Now you have all the information you need regarding DKIM records. You should be able to create and adjust DKIM records as you like. If you encounter any issues, feel free to reach out to our support team who are always happy to assist.